You heard who I am. Andrew Wagner, the editor of ReadyMade. That's not my presentation, I swear to you. Let's see. Oh, there we go, ReadyMade. It's a nearly 10-year-old design magazine and has a distinct do-it-yourself bent to it. When I first was asked to speak today, I really knew exactly what I wanted to talk about. And there's one thing in particular I wanted to focus on. About a year ago, when I came on board at ReadyMade, we went through a redesign process, and we started looking at what the magazine was, who our readers were, what they thought about us, blah, blah, blah. And we really focused in on this thing that we started to call mindful consumption, that we felt really represented our readers. Well, what is mindful consumption? I can tell you what it is, and I can tell you what it isn't. I'm Gen X, I'm 37. When I was growing up, a phrase that continually stuck with me in regard to Gen X was mindless consumption. And that was the constant intake of material goods with little to no concern about where they came from and how they got into the hands of the end user. That was particularly noticeable in suburban California in the 80s and 90s, and that's where I grew up also. When Gen X grew up, it was pre-easy access to the internet. I didn't have email till I graduated college, or maybe I had some weird email address in 1995. But we were deluged with marketing messages, and the majority of them were dishonest and manipulative. Then the medium was the message. But while working on the ReadyMade redesign, we noticed that with a large part of our audience, the Gen Ys, the millennials, there was a distinct change in the way they interacted with the material world. This new generation controls the mediums. They control what they watch, what music they listen to, who or what they read, what food they eat. In essence, they control how they perceive and experience the world, not the other way around. And that's a huge difference from my upbringing. Everything was pretty much force-fed to you, force-fed to Generation X. We also noticed that Gen Y grown up overexposed and highly educated about the material marketplace. This is an Andreas Gursky photo. I saw someone else used it too, but it's an amazing shot. Information on almost everything they pulled from the shelves was available at the click of a button. And this extensive knowledge led to a new type of consumer behavior and expectations. This consumption was and still is conspicuous, but is no longer mindless. Gen Y is hyper-aware of the realities of the products they engage with and expect a transparency that is really brand new in the marketplace. And as everyone has mentioned before, look no further than Obama sweeping into office on that very platform. They expect a real connection to what they spend their money on. They value individuality, community, and creativity. And what I think is most interesting and most important is they really demand an authenticity that up until a few years ago, authenticity was really sort of owned by a few outsider brands and a few cultural circles. ReadyMade is really rooted in a do-it-yourself ethos that sprouted from the late 60s and 70s hippie movements and changed course in the 80s and 90s as punk rock exploded. Punk rock bands took hold of their music and created their own venues and distribution systems that allowed music to flourish. Oh, can we not play that yet? Well, we'll play it because I love it. Go for it. This is Bad Brain, circa 1979.
I'm going to the fight, take a ball, but they're right to wait, take a rest of the
So that was Bad Brains 1979 at CBGB's, which unfortunately doesn't exist anymore. I just love it. I think it's just an amazing, amazing, amazing thing. And what I find most interesting about it is, yes, I really love Bad Brains. I think the song is amazing. So what I find most amazing about it is that they were a band of four young black men in late 1970s. And they were jazz-educated musicians. They were really incredible musicians. But they were immersed in a really largely white counterculture that completely rejected standard musical forms. But yet they still found a way to communicate via much of the values that I mentioned above, which was creativity, individuality, transparency, and most importantly, authenticity. They were able to break into this scene and basically dominate it. If anyone's into punk rock, they're one of the most influential bands to come out of that scene. So I think that's really important to remember, and that clip was intended to show just how raw they were and how real they were and how real they were to themselves and what they were doing. So they really broke through any societal barriers that existed by using those values and communicating directly with their audience on a really visceral level. And those are the same values that really helped establish ReadyMade when we started in 2001. It was just, I like to call it a really, it was the most glorified zine, and it really just exploded and grew from there. And we've really become a leader amongst a really notoriously difficult group to pin down. But we constantly have to change what we're doing, and we constantly have to take a new approach to what we're doing and how we're doing it and find new ways to communicate. So in light of that, I want to share just two recent projects that we've been involved with. First one, well, both of them are by the same group called Macro C, and they're a small little group within this very big development company. And basically they go out into the world and they create these really wild, interesting, crazy projects. We got involved with them because last summer they created these swimming pools in Brooklyn, in this Brooklyn empty lot out of dumpsters, out of construction dumpsters. And they basically created this amazing country club where the community could come in and people could swim. You had to be invited because it's a private lot, but really creating something out of nothing. And used as a marketing tool, but really also created just out of their curiosity of what you could do with these things and how could they work and how could the community use them and how could they be done differently. So really amazing project that got a lot of attention. The second one is a newer project that we started working on them with that they call Glasphemy, and it's in the same lot. And essentially what it is they really wanted to explore the idea of recycling and this idea that recycling had become a huge bore and everybody was sick of hearing about green this, green that, but yet it's still really important. So how do you make it something exciting and something that people can interact with? So we're working with them to run a contest based on, essentially what you do is you come up to this thing and they've collected all the beer bottles from all the bars around Brooklyn. And you get to come up and you just get to smash bottles, which people love to death, obviously. It's a lot of fun to break things. So people come over, they smash things, they destroy things, and then what do you get left with? You get left with a ton of broken glass. But the idea is, what can we do with that? Now, how can we reuse that? So we're running a contest now, ReadyMade is, and basically the group Macro C will create the winning entry, and they will actually make it happen, and they'll bring it to life and use it as part of what they're doing. So again, both things here I think are important because they're really created out of just honest curiosity and a real interest in the communities they affect. And both were created to engage an audience, which is hugely important. So our readers, they don't want to be preached to. They want to be shown and they want to participate. They want to be given knowledge and then be allowed to form their own opinions. And this newfound lust for knowledge about everything around us is not going to go away, but it will only continue to develop at a more rapid rate, obviously forcing companies to retool their approach to marketing and selling to Gen Y and future generations. Now, while it's causing havoc in some areas, it's also presenting countless opportunities for companies, both large and small, willing to embrace this consumer engagement and transparency. So going forward, I just want to suggest a new ethos of mindful consumption. Practice what you preach, put your money where your mouth is, and remember that nothing is so powerful as the truth. Thank you.